Dear students, good morning to all of you. Today we are going to see lesson 8, computer virus. In this lesson, today's class, we are going to study the topic, what is a computer virus and how virus enters the computer and the symptoms of a computer virus. These three topics only today we are going to see. First, you must know what is a virus, what it will do. Suppose we got fever. What is the cause of the fever? Or cold? For that, the reason is virus. So, virus will infect our body and it will create some problem to our health. Like the same, here also, computer virus is a program that introduced into our system and it corrupt or destroy the data in our computer. First, you must know what is the meaning of computer virus. Computer virus, it is a Latin word and it means poison. And what is the expansion of the virus? Vital, information, resource and a sage. Okay. The computer virus infects the computer negatively by altering the way the computer works without the user's knowledge or permission. Without our permission, the computer virus enters into our computer and it spreads from one computer to another computer. And it destroys our files or programs. Okay. Now, you see how virus enters to the computer. There are several ways by which your computer gets a virus. Some of them are as follows. First one, from CD, pen drive or other portable devices. When you are using CD, you all know whenever you are using computer, you can use CD, pen drive and other devices. So, whenever you are using the CD, through the CD, the computer virus may enter into our computer and also through the pen drive. Some other portable media to transfer the data from one computer to another. So, these type of media get infected sometime and when anyone inserts or attaches these infected media to the system, then virus may enter into our system. Second one, from email. We are very familiar with the email. And whenever you are using our computer to check our email and the virus will spread to our computer through the email attachment. The attachments that we receive from unknown users may be virus. So, you should not open the unknown person's mail. Known person, friend or relative that you can open and see. Others, unknown person's email you should not open into our system. There may be a chance of getting virus through that. Next, from the internet. Virus may enter through various malicious websites. Suppose you are using internet, you may have so many websites. And unwanted websites, unknown websites, if you open and if you search for some other information into that, through that also there may be a chance to get virus into our computer. That only given here. For example, when you download some files from the internet, these may be infected files which put your computer at risk. Next one, from a computer network. A computer network is a large collection of several computer systems connected by a large and main computer called a server. The main computer is known as the server. The other computers connected to the server are known as the client. So, through the network also, there is a possibility of getting virus, computer virus into our computer. These computers constantly share information. Any infected file may spread the virus. Next, symptoms of a computer virus. What are all the symptoms? How can you find the virus is entered into our computer? First point, the computer might run slower. Whenever you are running the computer, it may slow. It might corrupt your system files. Whenever you are opening the system files, you can find some other files may be corrupted. It might make some programs faulty or corrupt. Some programs which is in our computer, that may be faulty, that shows fault. It might steal important information from your computer and send them to other people through the internet. So, whenever you are using internet, you should be careful. Through the internet also, there may be a chance of stealing our information from our computer to other people through the internet. Next, application programs on the computer do not work correctly or smoothly. Whenever you are working on your programs, application programs, you cannot get the correct answer or some problem it may create. Then you can understand our computer is affected by computer virus. The computer locks up by itself frequently, which means that it stops responding to a command. So whenever you are using, you are giving some command, it will not respond. That shows that our computer may get computer virus. Next one, it makes endless copies of infected files on the system. It may replicate the copies of our files. Replicates means more than one copy. Again and again, you can get the same file. Next, strange sounds or beeping noises come from the computer or keyboard. Whenever you are pressing the keyboard or you are using mouse and selecting something, means that will create some noise, unknown strange sounds. Next, unusual error messages are displayed on the computer monitor. Usually, you may have some error message whenever you are doing something wrong. But unusual error messages, if you get on your system, you can understand that the computer virus is there. Next, the hard drive often runs out of free space. Whenever you are opening the hard drive, that shows no space. That is also one of the reason of your computer virus. So these are all the points you should keep in mind. That is the symptoms of the computer virus. Okay. Shall we see the next one? Just types of computer viruses. There are so many types of computer viruses. Next class we see elaborately. Today I'll give you the points alone. First one, boot sector virus. Next, email viruses. Next, program or file viruses, worms, Trojan horse, and macro viruses. These are all the topics and also the remaining we will see in the next class. Now, what you have to do, just read this lesson and do the activity. And also at the back side of your book, you are having practice assignment that also you try to do by yourself. Okay. Thank you, students.